Move 90.5 FM WGSJBC Radio. Don't forget, we've given away those tickets, y'all. We're giving away those tickets. Sunday, July 19th, we're giving away those tickets to the Harold Washington Culture Center. So if you want some tickets to this play, Jackie's Secret Life, give me a call, 708-343-3906. That's 708-343-3906. Smooth 90.5 FM. Come on, y'all. This is the Rob G Afternoon Drive Show. Our new show called Singles and Mingle. We are live. In effect, we are live. The lady's taking a little water break right now, so we got to do our commercial thing as always. Smooth 90.5 FM, that's Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJBC Rego. We also have tickets to the Tyler Perry play as well, so if you're interested, we got tickets. I have two front row tickets to the Tyler Perry play. Two tickets to the Tyler Perry play, so if you are looking, you want to see Madea, we got those tickets, y'all. Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJBC Radio. Smooth in the house. That's right. Singles and Mingles Day. Come on, Singles and Mingles Day. We're talking about being single and mingling. What's better for you? So we got some relationship questions and topics that'll be going on. Don't forget, the phone number is 708-343-3906. 708-343-3906. Smooth 90.5 FM. Don't forget to go to our website at WGSJBCRadio.com. That's WGSJBCRadio.com. Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJBC Radio. And don't forget, we got our hats. As y'all can see, we got our hats. We're live on TV as well, on live stream TV. So we got brand new hats, brand new coffee mugs. We have brand new t-shirts. Y'all got to tune in every day and listen to us. Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJBC Radio. We're here live, live in effect. Smooth 90.5 FM. Give us a call. We're taking you way back with Earth, Wind, and Fire. September. This is the remix, y'all. Yeah, y'all got to give me a call. Smooth 90.5 FM. Oh, Mr. Yvonne, you like them headphones, huh? Don't be trying to take my headphones off the studio. You're looking like, oh, what kind of headphones are these? I like these. They better than Beat headphones, right? They better. Sound better. Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJ, BC Radio. We're live. We're on Channel 10 and Channel 96. So, y'all, come on. Y'all tune in and listen to us. That's right. We are live in effect. Smooth 90.5 FM. Do I have somebody calling into our station already? Okay, we're going to see who this is in a few seconds. Smooth 90.5 FM, WGSJBC Radio. You're live on the air. You're live on the air. Who is this calling in? You're live on the air.
Yeah, my name is Jay. I'm calling in regards to your single and mingling. I got a question for the young lady, Miss Yvonne.
Go ahead, Mr. Jay.
Yeah, Miss Yvonne, I got a personal question I'd like to ask you.
Oh, hold on. This ain't Steve Harvey Morning Show, man. You're not going to be performing, trying to marry or propose doing like on Shirley Strawberry.
Yeah, with the age that you guys are, what kind of men do you guys attract?
Well, mine is 54 years old, so, period.
Because this is a long-distance call. I'm calling from Cleveland, Ohio.
Uh-huh.
Go ahead. I just would like to know, she has a beautiful voice, and I'd like to know, what kind of men do you attract when you're out taking care of your business?
Well, I get a lot of attention, but I know who I am. I know what I'm doing, and I just do what I do and keep it moving because I know whom I belong to.
So basically what you're telling me is you like to just keep it professional.
Certainly.
You don't attract any type of person that just walks up on you and decide that, you know, he can be anybody, that he can be why he's talking to you. He can say he's a millionaire. That doesn't faze you.
It doesn't. No, sir.
Okay, thank you.
You're welcome.
Is there anything else you want to ask anyone else, Jay?
Well, actually, her client, the comedian.
I noticed that
she said that she was engaged with children. And how does that work out for you?
She didn't say she was engaged with children, but...
No, I bust my eggs on Easter. No kids for me.
Oh,
That's over with. If I had a kid at my age, it's going to look like Benjamin Button.
So let me say this to you guys. We're listening to your program, and I noticed that they were talking about a comedy club that had dildos in the window in Chicago. Is that when you go to a venue and that kind of catches you off guard, are you still able to keep it professional where you can go in there and maybe if you got a clean act, keep it clean? Or do once you see that, does that take you to the next level?
I usually play off of stuff like that. And if it was clean, believe me, that would be in there. So, but if it's like that kind of setting, I would definitely play off of that. And that really helps because a lot of times things that catch you off guard is the funniest.
Right, because I noticed I was listening to the program. I'm actually at work with about 9 coworkers. We work at the Big Kitchen. I can't actually say the name of the facility. I got in trouble for that once before.
Oh, I see.
But we're actually listening, and a lot of my coworkers are amused about the topic, single and mingling, and that you guys are both taking. So that kind of just kind of threw us off. But the conversation is definitely interesting. So they kind of pushed me to call in. I guess I would be what they call a spokesman.
Okay.
Jay, let me ask you this question. Let me ask you this question, Jay. Are you single?
Absolutely not. Yeah. I am taken. Okay. I am happy. I am blessed. And I am in love.
All right. Okay.
At 55.
Oh, okay.
Well, then you ain't singling and mingling then.
I'm not. But, you know, the topic, you know, it kind of got me off.
We're going to change that topic
because
right now.
I wanted to listen to this.
Well, the title of the show, Jay, is called Single and Mingling, and the purpose of the show is to talk with single women, single men, women that are engaged or married, it's vice versa, and we're trying to get from each individual their point of view from dating the things and issues that you go through with dating. It's not a relationship hour show, but it's talking about being single and mingling. What's the difference? We're breaking it down. What are the issues as a single man, as a single woman, go through with trying to date? What are some of your pet peeves? What turns you on? What turns you off? What is it?
It's like representation. I always tell my girl, who is in the entertainment industry, that image is very important.
Uh-huh.
Because how you project yourself is how people take yourself.
Mm-hmm.
So that means if you're single, you can't be dressing. I mean, if you're taken, you can't dress like you're single because that's how men perceive you as. Wow, she must. I know she has to be single.
Well, that was the question I asked. I asked the women. When you're out with your girlfriends, do you project that image of being a single woman, or do you project that image of being I'm taken? Sometimes your attire, your clothing can also project an image that, hey, don't come and approach me because I'm single. Just like with me, I am a man. I'm drawn to women that have nice feet and they wear heels. So when you wear stiletto heels and everything and looking all sexy, 99% of the time that says that I'm single. I'm mingling, you know.
Could you say that again, please, one more time?
Did you not? Okay, I said, as a man, for me, when I see a woman that has on a pair of like stiletto heels and things on, of that nature, most of the times that kind of say, hey, that they're single.
Married women don't go out. That's not true. I'm not gonna be dressed like no nun. You know
what you just said,
uh-huh,
is what I've been telling my girl for the last year and a half. Because
also, I got a guy on my side. Is that what it is?
That's what I'm saying.
Oh,
well, I have been preaching this for a year and a half. How men perceive women, how they look.
Okay.
I'm gonna tell you this. I'm in a long distance relationship, and I carry myself just like my woman is right here on a daily basis.
Okay.
I got 1,900 people that work with me.
Uh huh.
Even before I got with my girl, that's how I carried myself.
Mm-hmm. Uh huh.
It's like I had a woman, because image is everything.
Mm-hmm. Were you in a truck stop or something?
Because I want to pass the mic.
Radio at work.
Oh, okay.
Like I said, we're sitting in a room listening to your program.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
We all took a break to listen to this because we were kind of interested.
Well, thank y'all very much for tuning in.
Hi, everybody.
Hey, everybody. Hey. Welcome, welcome. We got new listeners.
They're just shaking their heads. Me being a spokesman, I have a lot of spokesmen, and I am a very, 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 very inquisitive person, because I want to know. And what you just said just topped my day off on this conversation, because I have been preaching that to my girl for the last year and a half.
All right.
How important image is and how men perceive. Now, dating is 100% different than when I was dating. I'm 55 years old, but I still have certain pet peeves that I go. I can't take you home to my mother.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm not going to take you home to my mother, I'm not going to be with you, because you have to have the image that you're my girl.
Mm-hmm.
That consists of teamwork, you know. Image is everything. Even when we in public together, your attire that you wear, the way you your eyes accentuate, the way the lights hit you. You know, you could be sitting at a club and have a table full of women sitting there, and you could almost pick out the ones that has a husband or a boyfriend, and pick out the ones that are out here looking for a husband or a boyfriend. I see it over and over again.
So it
and
seems
the young people have changed it. They have raised the bar on dating. They talk about dots and hood rats and Gucci mamas and all of that. Some people want that because they don't have that at home. So when they bring themselves out in the street, that's what they're looking for. And once they hook up with this girl, if they do hook up with this girl by the grace of God, then they want to change their image. But you knew how she was before you met her, before you got with her.
Okay.
Know? And it's an old record that says the same thing it took to get your woman, it's going to take the same thing to keep your woman. And how you start is how you finish.
Tracy holding up her hands like she in grade school, like she got to go to the bathroom. Excuse me, teacher. Let's hear from Ms. Fox.
I'm
go ahead.
I'm trying to be discreet and cool, but see, you keep busting me out. But I wanted to say something to Jay. I'm going to say I politely and respectfully disagree when it comes to women wearing stilettos or heels, because sometimes we just want to look sexy because we got a man, too. We do it for ourselves, but there's nothing wrong with getting up. I'm feeling good. Sex was great last night, so I want to wear some heels. A dress.
Yeah, but if you're dating, Tracy,
you can still be a lady and wear heels.
You
can
still wear stilettos and mini skirts when you're with me.
Well, I get that.
Not when you're going out with Bonquisha, Aisha, Alizé, Mercedes.
I got you. I don't know Laquita and Fatima.
Is, look, I need you to buy me some drinks, and we might be able to hook up
after
the club.
But I'm
that's
just saying,
image. It might not be your intention, but as men, that's what we look at.